Now I have my quibbles. We're not going to get into that.
Sorry about that. Listen to Yvette, you know, going off because, you know how Yvette and they always attack the celebrities and stuff. I just saw this. We are picking on Diddy and celebrities, question mark. The Tuskegee's influence on our health. That's what I'm listening to next. I just started it, so I don't know what she's saying. But here's my thing about celebrities and all these people. I'm not talking about Yvette now, but, you know, whatever they think is. I do the Neely Fuller Jr. way. It's like, they said what they said. I have nothing to say. They said what they said. What do you think about what they said? Well, they said what they said. Well, what do you think about this? Well, about the topic? Well, here's what I think about the topic. Now, I don't have to comment on what they said. I don't have to rebut what they said. It's the same thing we get in with Donald Trump. Well, you know, it's like we react to what Donald Trump said. Well, why are you doing that? He said what he said. What did you... Why am I talking to you about this? I'm off course already because... Because I'm me, T, from the Pattersons, taking the train to Tibet. T being me, that's the me, T, right here. And I'm going to talk to you for a little bit right now. Actually, it's going to be short. Like, oh, look at this. I got some chocolate. Intense chocolate, 60% cacao. Wow, I don't know I had this. I eat this later. But, drinking water. We're still in the pandemic. Which is why I'm talking to you from an undisclosed location. So you still should be drinking your water. In fact, you should have been going long enough that you should have developed these new habits. You know what I mean? But one of the things, just real quick, I just realized I don't want to get into the whole thing. I have this whole backstory about my relationship with money, with finance, with economy, whatever it is. But I've always sort of monitored some weird, you know, I read so many diverse things, and I sort of, anyway, it doesn't matter. Let me go back to an early day. Something I just realized, because all the stuff they were talking about, the puts and the all of us they talked about, and I realized that long ago in the 80s, because you know I grew up in a certain era, whatever have you, and one of the people that's always been in my background is Melvin Van Peebles, right? And just from the early days, Sweetback first came out. I won't get into that, but so I've been following Melvin from the very, 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 very beginning. I've seen all his plays on, even one of them, Don't Play Us Cheap on Broadway, Ain't Supposed to Die a Natural Death, all those things. I've seen the plays and everything like that. At one point, I was in such a tear with Melvin that he wrote a book. He wrote a book on finance, and I looked it up on the thing, and I read this book a long time. I forgot because it was about like puts and, you know, how you, anyway, the name of the book is Bold Money, New Ways to Play the Options. I think it's supposed to be the options. Yeah, the options market. And I understood when the book was thinking, but I've always had this relationship with Wall Street, whatever, with finance. And I realized this long ago as I'm going like, because at some particular point, even that same time in the 80s when I was listening to reading Melvin's book, it's a good book. You'll understand the stuff when you read it. And you'll understand that, you know, it's all a game. It's all gambling. You know what I mean? Which is what I came to in gambling because in the 80s, I used to listen to NPR a lot. Because where was I? No, not in the 80s. In the early 90s, I used to listen to NPR a lot because I was traveling around. And anyway, the NPR stations, I would get them wherever I was in Florida, wherever it was at. And I realized at some particular point, you know, I said, because I was listening to all kinds of programs when they had that marketplace thing, whatever they had, those programs they had to finance. Then I was saying like, if I had some money, I'd invest in that. But that's the point. If I had some money, but you see, okay, so I bring all this stuff up. That's to say now with this whole virus and everything, now with the whole economic system disrupted and everybody's doing what every person for themselves kind of thing. You know what I mean? That's why, you know, you do things for friends. So if your friends are all bankers and real estate people, you're going to do stuff for them. You have no friends in the downtrodden. You know what I mean? Think about it. How many ask these big financial people, how many downtrodden friends do you have? When you go and you want to shape out a bill, do you go to your downtrodden friends or do you go to your banker friends? You know what I mean? See, as Joe Biden, your good friends. Do you go to your good friends? Like Joe Biden goes to his good friends? Or do you go to, it doesn't matter. I mean, let me put it this way. If it wasn't for Eleanor Roosevelt, you know, hanging out with some people that Franklin wasn't hanging out with, then you wouldn't have what you were having today. That's all I can say with that. Shortcut way. So I was talking about just that. So it's just very interesting to me how people would get. I think that what's happening now, you have to use precise language, where people, we don't know who's talking about what. Because every time one of these politicians, let's call these people, make over, they have over $1 million or million whoever, right? When they're talking about their million orientation. You see what I'm saying? They have no idea. You know what it is to be stuck at 2 o'clock in the morning, and you can't get home in the middle of Staten Island. They don't know. What do they know? And, or the middle of Kentucky, or whatever. Speaking about Kentucky, somebody said to St. Louis. Somebody wrote me. Somebody sent me a thing. St. Louis. All the cases that with the coronavirus in St. Louis. I think it's St. Louis. They're all black. You know what I mean? Which goes to show, again, just things is exposing underlying systems. This whole thing with the viruses, yeah, everybody should get tested, whatever have you. But the problem is not if you get tested or not. The problem is that you have, I hope this data comes out. If most of the people that are dying from this virus that are black, let me put it that black, that ADOS, if all of them have underlying conditions, then you have to say, hey, why are we trying to, we're putting all this money into testing, which is good, and to finding a virus, and when you find an immunization for it or a virus for it, that's usually a year later anyway. Why can't we start looking into some things that these underlying conditions, what caused those underlying conditions, and deal with that? Put some money into that. Just give me your time to think. I drink, you think. I'm sorry. I drink water, you think with your brain, right? So anyway, so I just wanted to make that real, just really little thing because everybody's going to come at this a different way. I mean, I was listening to some people who deal with the economy from South Africa, and they look at it differently. You know, everybody looks at it differently because you have a different situation. So just know your situation, you know. Don't spend no money that you don't have. You know what I mean? I guess now everybody knows about debt. Before I said, don't go into debt. Don't go into that. And hopefully, I need to be more groomed. Just before this thing hit, the barbershop that I went to in Harlem, you know what I mean? They had to stop, you know what I mean? But I'm sure that people are going to find little innovative ways to do what they need to do. Believe me, I think the first people is going to open back up. It's like, you know, barbers, you know, a little barber here, barber there, you won't get the virus and da-da-da-da-da. Anyway. I talked a little bit too long, but I'll see you later. It's still on.